The twice impeached, convicted of 34 felony counts, former President Donald Trump essentially admitted to law enforcement in the state of New York that he is in fact still committing a very serious crime. A crime so bad that police in New York have now had to alert authorities in the state of Florida to the fact that, hey, this guy who claims your state as his legal residence is committing a crime in your state. Please do something about it. So what is that crime? That crime, according to the pre-sentencing hearing that Donald Trump had with Judge Juan Marshan, is that he still owns a gun. Even with 34 felony convictions against him, he has not yet surrendered one of his firearms that allegedly, according to the hearing, is down at Mar-a-Lago. He has, of course, three total firearms, or did, according to what he had told authorities when he was indicted. Two of those were surrendered to authorities in New York once he got indicted. He kept one. And in the pre-sentencing hearing, he was asked, hey, you turned in two, but you had three. Where's the third gun? Well, the third gun is down at Mar-a-Lago. Okay, you're a felon now. Whether you want to admit it or not, you are, in the eyes of the law, a convicted felon, which means it's illegal for you to own a gun. So you got to turn in the gun. So that's why authorities in New York have alerted authorities down here in Florida to say, hey, you got a felon running around with a gun. We don't know where it is. He's not allowed to have it. You got to do something about it. I mean, New York City Police Department has now notified police in Florida and asked them to take appropriate action. Now, if only... Now, granted, I was on vacation all last week and I wasn't paying much attention to the news, but I mean, do we have any other instances where any kind of high profile people were recently arrested for, or convicted, I should say, for having an illegal gun? I mean, right? That's not something that a high profile person would get convicted for, right? No, of course it happened last week. Hunter Biden was in fact convicted for owning an illegal gun. And now here's Donald Trump, who has 34 felony convictions against him, openly admitting to the judge, like, yeah, I got a gun. It's down in Florida. What? What of it? Like, this shouldn't be a matter of police saying, like, hey, you got to take appropriate action. It should be a matter of police saying, okay, cool. Here's an arrest warrant. You just admitted to a crime. You have now had several weeks to turn over that firearm. You knew, because you had already surrendered your other two back in 2023, that this was something you had to do. You failed to do what was required by the law. Therefore, you should be criminally charged. It's stuff like this that actually drives me up the wall. Because if this were any other person in this country that got convicted of a felony, then 2.5, 3 weeks later, we find out they still have a gun, that person would not be given special treatment. They would immediately be arrested, hit with new charges, and have to go through another criminal trial. But not Trump. Nope. I imagine authorities will eventually go knock on the door. The Secret Service will say, okay, here's the gun. And authorities will say, thank you very much. We'll see you never. And that'll be the end of it. But if it were anybody else in this country, criminal charges would have already been filed. The FBI or local police will have knocked down their door to get their hands on that illegal firearm. But because it's Trump, as per usual, nothing happens. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.